Would you like to be an expert fruit and veg shopper to pick the perfect pears or maybe land the juiciest lemon? Well, if you just can't seem to get it right, don't fret because we have some fantastic tips and tricks for you. Joining us this morning is greengrocer and fruit and veg expert Peter Morelli. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
In fact, you're Jessica Rowe's local grocer, greengrocer.
I am indeed.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes.
Now, you've just been named runner-up for the Greengrocer of the Year in the 2017 Fresh Awards. That is a huge honour.
Thank you very much.
Did you get like a little
trophy in the shape of a banana? Yeah, no, not as a banana, but a nice little trophy, yeah, and that was awesome.
Fantastic.
So how do we go about picking the very best fruit and vegetables? I mean, look at these blueberries. They're the fattest, most beautiful blueberries I've ever seen.
Blueberries at the moment, this is the time for blueberries, especially for kids, antioxidants. They're big, they're plump, they're fantastic. This is the time
Full of vitamin C, aren't they?
Yeah, very much so.
Would you like one, Sarah?
Oh, I've been eating them non-stop. They're on special at the moment as well. And strawberries as well.
Blueberries.
How do you pick a good strawberry?
Good strawberry, full colour. Mm-hmm. You don't want anything with a green shoulder on it. So as long as it's a nice full colour, it means the berry is ripe, it's ready to eat. With strawberries, you need to eat them at a room temperature. That's the problem. A lot of people eat them straight out of the fridge and eat them, and they say there's no flavour.
That's so true.
You need to have strawberries at room temperature.
But they only last on the counter at home for a day or two, don't they?
Oh, yeah, tops. Look, if you're having a party or something, a couple of hours before, bring them out.
Yep.
And that's plenty.
Okay.
I like these little apples. I bought some the other day.
Yes.
Because they're just a good size for a nibble.
Well, they're a new variety, actually.
What are they called?
They're a rocket apple. And they're targeted for kids, hence the size of the actual apple. And they're crunchy and sweet.
Yeah, I found it quite sweet.
Very crunchy.
But sweet, lovely.
Yes.
Really nice apple.
Sometimes when you're getting an orange, it can be really dry inside and not as juicy as you'd hoped. How do you pick the perfect juicy orange?
Okay, we want something with a little bit of spring in it. We don't want it too firm because when it's too firm, it means it's gone a bit on the dry side inside.
Okay. So you actually have to sit there and squeeze it.
Well, you don't have to squeeze it, just a little. As long as it's got a bit of give in it.
Around the side?
Yeah.
You'll see what it
as long as it's got a bit of give in it.
Okay.
But some varieties are harder than others. We've got to consider that also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Asparagus?
Asparagus, we're moving into Australian season time now, so this is the time that we should be eating asparagus.
Mm-hmm.
So
how do you pick a good one?
Look, as long as the spears are nice and straight, and the best way to store asparagus is in the fridge, just in a cup with a little bit of water.
Put a bag over it. Store them like that, aren't you?
Exactly.
In the water.
Yeah. And the water, the asparagus will actually drink the water.
Do you need to cut the ends off?
Yes.
How far?
Just slightly.
Oh, okay.
Right?
No,
because most asparagus now, the varieties are very nice and tender. You want to keep away from thick asparagus because they're a bit woody.
Okay.
Yeah. What about those amazing looking tomatoes? They're tomatoes, aren't they?
Yes, to die for. These are ox heart tomatoes.
They're a bit more expensive than the general ones.
Yeah, a lot more expensive, actually.
They're yummy.
Ox heart.
To die for.
So what's so good about them?
They are full tomato flavour, full flesh inside, ideal for caprese salads with a bit of bocconcini, a bit of basil on top, or you can do a nice bruschetta with them.
You can eat it like an apple as well.
You can.
I've noticed that the truss tomatoes are the same price as the regular tomatoes at the moment.
We're in abundance with tomatoes at the moment.
So is it better to buy the vine ripened?
Yes, always.
Why is that?
Because the actual tomato is ripened on the vine, opposed to being picked green, packed and shipped.
Fantastic.
Yeah, the truss tomatoes always taste more like a tomato.
A lot more.
And do you throw these in the fridge or in the fruit bowl?
No, you can put them in the fridge. And like strawberries, bring them out once you want to eat them. You don't want to eat them cold.
No.
Nothing's nice cold, to be quite honest.
So they have to breathe.
You don't get the full flavour.
Like a wine.
Yes, very much so.
Now, this is a great cauliflower. It's got no marks. It's a nice white
Beautiful snow white cauliflower. And this is the time to buy cauliflower. They're relatively cheap.
And they disappeared for a bit in the supermarket during the winter. I thought, I can't find a cauliflower. Where have they gone?
Well, they're like us. We don't like to go out when it's cold. We hibernate, You know what I mean?
What is going on with avocados at the moment too? Because it used to be super expensive. Really?
Yes.
I'm getting them 2 for $5 at the moment.
Well, depending on
times must be tough.
You never know where your avocado has been.
But because isn't it if they're really, really green, they're not quite ripe, and then when they turn much browner, they're ripe?
With the actual variety, which is at the moment, which is called a Hass avocado, it's really good for the consumer because when they're green, the avocado is green, and it will change colour to a darkish black colour when it's ripe. Mm-hmm. So it's easy to identify when the avocado is ripe.
Mm-hmm. So do you put them in the fridge? I do.
Yeah.
Now, after if you cut it open?
If I cut them open, I very quickly put the glad wrap around and I put the seed down and they usually stay
You've got to keep the seed in, don't you?
Yeah.
If it's ripe, yes, put it in the fridge. But if you want to buy avocados, I generally steer my customers to buy greener avocados and let them ripen in the fruit basket. Yeah. Once they're ripe, put them in the fridge, sure, no problem.
And green bananas as well. We go through a pile of bananas at home with the little boy. So do you buy them green so they last a little bit longer
Yeah,
the
they generally pick the bananas green because they've got a long way to travel up from Queensland and far north Queensland, right? And then we put them in a ripening process, which we ripen a good local greengrocer will do all that for you and take all that stress out of it for you. You know what I mean?
Is that a mandarin?
They are actually called a sumo fruit, which is half tangelo, half mandarin. And they're an easy peel fruit, and they're only available all around for about a month and a half, which this is the time to buy them, and they're super sweet. They're amazing.
Wow. It's got a bit of personality about it, doesn't it? And the passion fruits, well, are in season. I've got to ask you, because you've got all gorgeous fruit and veg here, and there's been a rise of imperfect fruit and veg, ugly fruit and veg. Yep. Are they okay to buy?
Nothing wrong with them whatsoever.
Yeah.
Okay. A grower gets rewarded for a nice piece of fruit, but a grower doesn't just grow a nice piece of fruit. He grows a variance of fruit. So he'll get top dollar for that particular nice full bloom, you know, fruit, and then a little bit cheaper on the other fruit, but the taste-wise is exactly the same.
So I've seen weird things growing off carrots and that type of thing, but what you're saying is it's what's inside that counts.
Exactly, exactly.
There's a lesson in that for all of us, isn't there? Now, for some hot tips and excellent fruit and veg, you can head online to Parisa's Food Hall.
Parisi's
Food Hall, there we go, .com.au. Peter, you're wonderful.
Thank you
so much for joining
us. Pleasure.